From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Cam Tran. Some local retailers will be opening their doors in just a few hours, kicking off Black Friday. At the main mall, many people braved the cold and started to line up as early as 2 Thursday afternoon. And those shoppers had some big plans for the discounts offered during Black Friday.
I'm just here to have fun with all the friends. I really don't need a laptop. I really don't need anything. I'm just here for my friends.
Oh, I want to buy a TV. So I come from Pennsylvania. So I came to visit my friend also. So we are having this Thanksgiving get together. It's fun. It's always fun with friends. And also getting a good deal, being second in the line.
Yes, you heard it. The first person in line wasn't even there to buy anything. Perhaps he'll change his mind once he goes inside the store. Well, Brunswick police say a car crashed into a Walmart on Tibbetts Drive late Thursday afternoon. Officials say when they arrived, they found a blue Nissan against a concrete wall. The vehicle had some extensive front end damage. 47-year-old Andrea Kreetma was driving the car. She was transported to Maine Medical Center with non-life-threatening injuries. The crash is still under investigation. The state fire marshal's office is investigating an early morning fire Thursday that destroyed a family's home in South Paris. A passerby saw the fire. He was able to honk his horn, which helped get the three residents out of the house in time. Flames quickly engulfed the house before crews arrived. It took firefighters about 2 hours to get the two-alarm fire under control. Investigators say the house was destroyed. The American Red Cross and Salvation Army have been called in to assist the family. The cause of the fire has not yet been released. And in Raymond, Thursday afternoon, crews were busy containing a large brush fire. The section of Route 302 near the fire was shut down for a while as several fire departments responded to the blaze. Electricity was also cut to the area because the fire was creeping towards some power lines. And in Freeport, nearly 200 people enjoyed a free Thanksgiving Day dinner thanks to the owner of a local restaurant. For the seventh straight year, the owner of Azure Cafe, Jonas Warner, provided the food for what he calls a community celebration. Held now inside the town's community center, he says all of the hundreds of meals that he serves in a year, this one is the most special.
When you see them smiling and you've watched them interact with people in the community and you know that they feel more a part of where they live, it's a little different. Rewarding.
There's a moment every year when we're in the room where you just feel this overwhelming emotional sense that, wow, I'm really doing something great today.
Aside from what it serves here at the community center, Azure Cafe also prepares dozens of meals to volunteers which they deliver to people who are unable to leave their homes. Well, thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Cam Tran. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.